there is another option. For me, the bankruptcy is a very serious case. How did you sort of overcome that fear and had the smart to look beyond that when everyone is telling you it's about time to just close shop, file bankruptcy? What was it that drive that drove you?
Because I believe that if going for that is not an answer.
As a musician, I was a rap artist, did songs since I was 17. My songs on the radio include songs like Lang Loy. Yes, my ex-girlfriend was Chinese. It's really weird. My first song on radio was called Lang Loy. Everyone was like, jumping late, I saw my mom like, you need to represent Lang Loy. But my career started from music, and because my fans were all school kids, I realized that every kid in school has a smartphone, right? So I mind when I was in school, the worst I can do is play Snake on a Nokia Butterfly, right? But kids nowadays, they have a thing called smartphone. I don't call it smartphone, I call it Quasar. Why do I call this Quasar? I call it Quasar because when I was in school, the best thing I could do is play Snake, right? But nowadays, kids as young as 12 can put a tweet, Kawan I, the more or don't tweet. And someone's feelings would have been offended. For me, that's power, right? That's powerful. But at the same time, I can tweet, hey, kawan, Nis I sakit, kita tak mampu nak bayar dia punya hospital fees, tolonglah kita. Tweet, it goes viral, someone will help. So I just realized something has to be done. I was rapping, I was performing, every kid has a smartphone, and I told myself, if I don't talk to these youth now, these kids now, then I might be letting them down. They might enjoy my music, but that guy just wanted to leave it there. So I just persuaded myself I should start an IT company. So I called a few friends who are passionate about IT and programming. We built an e-learning.
Excuse me. Yeah. So you're actually from the zero background of IT, right?
Zero. I cannot program a single line of code.
So at first you find a team. That's.
I found my team. Yo, okay. I found my team. It was just the idea was to make learning fun. That was the objective. Adele has smartphone. The first app that we built was an e-gaming platform where we built games for math, science, English for kids to learn. A lot of kids in KL used it. We got a grant from, sorry, PDC, from a different agency. They gave me about half a million ringgit. So we built games. However, I did not follow the revenue model which they just advised. I didn't think about revenue. I thought about let's make learning fun. By the time that money finished and the games are out there, me and my partner sat down, how do we sell this? Every game on the iStore is free. Which better games. Angry Bird, all games are free. How do we sell this? We went broke. When we went broke, what do? I knocked on doors. I went to Parliament. Hey, sir, can you invest in my company? No. I knocked on over 42 doors. I won't say door number 43 was who, but door number 43 was someone very influential, ex-prime minister. He gave me some advice, and I ran with it. I didn't stop. We built a different platform called classroom.com. I ambil cikgu-cikgu tuition yang gempak kat KL ni. I put on my platform and sold tuition for 5 ringgit per subject on my app, which is 5 ringgit per subject. That's too cheap. And that like cikgu yang ajar tu memang cikgu known teachers in KL. And then that went viral. Majid Besar Johor supported it. And I sold it to Johor Corp for 2.6 million. And then, thank you. There's a long story behind that, you know. That's how it all started. I didn't code. Found people that code that believed in my vision. We failed the first time. Went broke, locked doors. Finally, we sold it to Johor Corp for 2.6, and then everyone was happy. Thank you for your question.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay.
Thank you. Any more questions for the floor? Yes, sir.
In Malaysia, Malaysian government is trying to help to support youngsters to have more entrepreneurs. In fact, by economic calculation, it's trying support new youngsters. So I just want to ask you, all the panel members, what type of advice you will give to the fresh graduates or youngsters to become a successful interview? Thank you.
Sure. Open the floor. Who wants to start? What kind of advice can we give to fresh graduates to become successful entrepreneurs? Mr. Sarvan, you start.
The thing is that there must be some interest. You should find out what is that. Because when you do something, put money aside, actually. Focus on interest. Achievement is important, actually. So find out what they really keep to do, and then go all out.
Is there a question to add to that?
I think like what I've gone through, I want to share, is at your age, like I was mentioning earlier, I still remember when I start thinking about where am I going to live my life to. When I was at the university, I saw my lecturer, what they do. So that is, you have that mindset. Setting your mind, yes, I want to do this, and until now, we never end. So there'll be a moment in your life where you think that this is what I want to do. And that moment you have to capture. But that will direct you the whole of your life. So that's how I feel about it.
Any more questions for the floor? We're about to have the closing statement, so this will be our last chance to ask any questions. Any more questions on the floor? Going once? Going twice? Alright. To my fellow panelists, it's been an honor to be here among you guys. Let's have a closing statement from all of us before we part ways. Starting with Mrs. Arvana, what is the best advice you can give to entrepreneurs out there? And
I think find something that you are keen to do. Work on it, never give up. Struggles will be there. But I'm sure that you guys have the struggle will be there. And at the end of the day, you will achieve. That's natural science in it. You will achieve. So don't give up.
Alright, Mr. Tan. Parting words and best advice you can give to young entrepreneurs today.
Jangan berebut-rebut, orang buat bisnes pun kita nak buat bisnes. So, with a purpose.
Right? That's all. Mau muda.
Saya ada tips sangat. Cuma, bila kita dah nak buat bisnes, kita buat dengan jujur dan pemetika. Kita jujur pada diri, kita jujur pada kelihatan kita, jujur pada kelihatan, insyaAllah berjaya. Doa lah orangnya.
Thank you. Last but not least, Mr. Nurisha, parting words and best advice you give to young entrepreneurs out there today?
My parting advice is just believe in yourself. And you don't give up. That is important. Thank you.
Well done. All right. Thank you so much, guys. Good morning.
Okay, thank you once again to Caprice.
You're here, I cannot hear you. I cannot hear you. I cannot hear you.
Let's go!
truth or in